Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I am going to talk about the final keyword. This is because I had a viewer specifically request that I do an episode on this topic. The viewer specifically asked, how and when should the final keyword be used? The first thing that you should know is where final can be used. If I were to declare this struct as a final struct, and I wanted to derive from this thing, I am going to get a compile error. I am not allowed to derive from a type that has been declared final. This is sometimes where you see final being used. Where you might be more likely to see it used, perhaps, is on function declarations. The rule here that I want to make sure I make very clear is at most use one of virtual, override, or final when declaring a member function. You can get into a very weird situation if you use this wrong. So in my more derived, if I wanted to go and make another override of this particular function, this is going to be allowed because go in derived is declared override. If I declare this member function final, then I am not allowed to override it on line 12. A main part of the point of override is to protect you from yourself. So if I have override here, and I go and I change this function signature to take an integer, I'm now going to get a hard compile error on line 8, because it's telling me that I'm not overriding a function from a base class. I must correct the function signature here so that they both have exactly the same function signature. Well, you're also allowed to use covariant return types, but that's a topic for a different episode. Where you can get yourself in trouble, now I'm going to go back to this one having no parameters, and we'll see that I get this compile error. I cannot override a function if it doesn't match the signature of a virtual function in a base class. I'm going to mark this final. Final is going to give me the exact same compile error. But if I do this, I am declaring a new virtual function that is final that hides a base class function. You can see I actually have warnings as errors here. It's warning that I hid an overloaded function. You might want to do that in some particular cases, but this is not a compile error. This is just a warning that because I have warnings as errors, the compiler actually caught it, which I would say this is a new warning to me. It's the first time I've actually seen the compiler catch this logic error in my code. Okay, we're going to get back to this final now. As we already said, I cannot override a member function that has been marked final. And the override keyword here doesn't actually change anything. Override protects us from ourselves. It does not change the meaning of the code in any way. It just says I'm expecting to override a function. Virtualness is inherited. So this is already a virtual member function, no question, but the compiler is stopping me from overriding it because it was marked final in derived. The question is when to use final. I will say there are other people that have done research that has yielded different results than my own research when it comes to performance. I will link to those in this video description. So make sure you check out the other articles. There is definitely some cases where using final might actually hurt performance. I will tell you where I have personally used final. I've used it when there is like a leaf in my inheritance, and I'm going to go ahead and mark this thing final. Actually, I'm going to change it so that the class itself is final. Now, if I have a function that takes a reference to a derived object, and in here I call d.go42. At this point in the compilation, the compiler has no way of knowing which function I'm calling. You and I can look at this and see that it's got to be either derived or inheritance leaf. But the compiler doesn't know that. It knows that I am calling a virtual function. This is a thing with a V table. It's going to load a pointer to the V table. It's going to load a pointer to the specific function that we want to call. And then it's going to jump to that memory address so that it can call the appropriate go function with the appropriate this pointer and the appropriate parameter 42 passed to it. If, however, I have a function that takes an inheritance leaf, the compiler knows at this point that it is not possible for anyone to further derive from inheritance leaf. Therefore, it knows that it can safely call this go function. Well, the go function does nothing, so it's optimized away. Let's go ahead and just forward declare it, which again is a great trick when using Compiler Explorer to see what the compiler is going to do. We can see that it loads 42, and then it does this jump. This is a tail call, and it can do a jump. It doesn't have to do a call, and this is great. This is well performing. So, what do we mean by an inheritance leaf? I'm going to say this. If I could say that it would be a programming error to further derive from this thing, there's no logical thing that I could do after this point, then I'm going to personally mark it final. Now, I will say, it's possible that you'll actually see a performance hit, and it's possible that you'll see performance improve. Like I said, there seems to be a bit of a controversy about this lately, and I will have links to those articles that discuss this with other tests that have been run. I can say in my own personal code, I saw a large performance improvement about 10 years ago. I tried the exact same test again with modern compilers, and it was more like only a 0.5% to a 1% performance improvement. So this is going to fall into the category of do this if it makes sense for the cleanliness and structure of your code. Where I would personally do this is, well, forgive me for the terrible inheritance example here, but if I've got some sort of struct that is a shape, and then I have a cube that derives from shape, I would be inclined to make cube final. This isn't a hard and fast rule. But in the cases where you might see performance improve, this is that kind of case because you might then end up doing something like getting the best of both worlds, where if you have some function that needs to do something like render some shape in a generic sense, then it can. But if you also happen to be doing a bit of data-oriented design and you have a vector of cubes, maybe it has to call the virtual member function. If I've got this vector of cubes, then maybe I can do some sort of I might be able to get some sort of data-oriented design performance win. If I am doing that kind of thing while also still keeping the generic flexibility of using virtual functions when I need to, and if I'm using the data-oriented design thing, I can safely have a vector of cubes because I know that it can't be any further derived type, so I don't have to worry about slicing, and I don't have to do dynamic allocation for each of the objects. I'm just saying it's something to consider here. This is where final can be used, and also an aside on best practices with override. So make sure you do use override when you intend to properly override a function in a base class. Make sure you never use more than one of virtual override or final at the same time, and use final when it would be a logic error to further derive from that thing. Also, read the articles that I'm going to reference in this video. So thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe. I'll catch you later.